Greetings. I recently read 1 John from beginning to end. I read it because I've seen Ahmed Didat try to use text from 1 John to support his erroneous teachings from Mohammedism. It's not that hard, because it is such a short letter to believers, but it is so rich with truth and encouragement, and so pure in its teachings on the Son of God. I've also created 3 videos reading 1 John from beginning to end. The third video I begin to teach on the content because there is just so much there. It is so good, so rich. After reading all of 1 John, I can see that 1 John causes huge problems for Islam. You see, 1 John calls Jesus the Son of God over and over. 1 John 1:3, "And truly our fellowship is with the Father and with His Son, Jesus Christ." 1 John 1:7, "And the blood of Jesus Christ, His Son, cleanses us from all sin." 1 John 2:22, "Who is a liar but he that denies that Jesus is the Christ? He is antichrist that denies the Father and the Son." 1 John 2:23, "Whosoever denies the Son, the same has not the Father. He that acknowledges the Son has the Father also." 1 John 2:24, "Ye also shall continue in the Son and in the Father." 1 John 3:8, "For this purpose the Son of God was manifested, that he might destroy the works of the devil." 1 John 3:23, "And this is his commandment, that we should believe on the name of his Son, Jesus Christ." 1 John 4:10, "Herein is love, not that we loved God, but that he loved us, and sent his Son to be the propitiation, or payment, for our sins." 1 John 4:14, "And we have seen and do testify that the Father sent the Son to be the Savior of the world." 1 John 4:15, "Whosoever shall confess that Jesus is the Son of God, God dwelleth in him, and he in God." 1 John 5:1, "Whosoever believeth that Jesus is the Christ is born of God, and every one that loveth him that begat, loveth him also that is begotten of him." You see, the Word of God says that God begat Jesus, and that Jesus is the begotten of the Father. That's what the Word of God says. Oh, I agree, it's not what the word of Muhammad says, but it's what the word of God says. 1 John 5:5, "Who is he that overcometh the world, but he that believeth that Jesus is the Son of God?" 1 John 5:9, "For this is the witness of God, which he has testified of his Son." 1 John 5:10, "He that believes on the Son of God has this witness in himself. He that believes not God has made him, God, a liar, because he believed not the record that God gave of his Son." 1 John 5:11, "And this is the record, that God has given to us eternal life, and this life is in his Son." 1 John 5:13, "These things have I written unto you that believe on the name of the Son of God, that you may know that you have eternal life, and that you may believe on the name of the Son of God." 1 John 5:20, "And we know that the Son of God is come, and has given us an understanding, that we may know him that is true, and we are in him that is true, even in his Son, Jesus Christ. This is the true God and eternal life." That is 17 mentions of Jesus Christ, the Son of God, in 1 John alone. 1 John 2:26. These things have I written unto you concerning them that seduce you. Beware, brothers, of the claims of Islam. The author of Islam wishes to seduce you away from the gospel of Jesus Christ, the Son of God. Always remember what 1 John 2:22 says. Who is a liar but he that denies that Jesus is the Christ? He is antichrist that denies the Father and the Son. If someone denies that Jesus is the Son of God, they belong to the spirit of antichrist that is in the world. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ, in whom we have eternal life. Amen.